Welcome back to your 10th AngularJS tutorial, and in this tutorial we'll be learning something called filters in AngularJS. So filters, as you expect, are way lot deep in concept than what we'll be learning in this tutorial, but it's always necessary to have a basic knowledge of what we are working with. So let me introduce you to filters in AngularJS. And filters are nothing much but simply a way of formatting your output nicely on the screen. So for that, to demonstrate that, let me create a simple app in Angular. Let's say it accepts just your name, and let's say ng model, this should be binded to name, and down here let's say welcome name. Alright, so here's the browser. Let's reload this, and let's say, alright, mail here, and we are good to go. So now let's say I want this to be capitalized automatically whenever I type anything right here. So what I can do is, I'll write this thing, my default one. I'll write a pipe, and this pipe is on my keyboard, it's just above enter, but located, it's a straight line, it's not I, it's a pipe symbol. And after typing that, I'll type my filter, which in this case is just uppercase. Now uppercase is a filter which would turn this text in uppercase. So when I reload this, you see that welcome is already turned into uppercase, and if I want this into lowercase, then I have to move this outside our expression of AngularJS. And now let's reload this, and let's say this thing. Now even though I am typing everything in small, you notice that it appears capitalized. Similarly, we have some filters like lowercase. Let's reload this, and now you can see even uppercase alphabets are appearing in lowercase. Then we have something called currency one. So let's say I change it to price here. And I write currency. So I'll reload this, and I'll write 10. So you see that it's automatically formatted as a currency, and a dollar sign is appended in front of it. But we could actually modify the currency symbol as well. So let's say if I want, instead of dollar, I want rupees. So I'll just write rupees because I don't have it. The symbol right now to copy and paste here. Now let's reload this, and now as you can see, we get the output in rupees. Now what if I don't want the decimal to be there? So what I can do is, I'll just type a colon again, and the places of decimals I want to show. For instance, I want to show zero decimal places or hide decimals. So I'll write zero, and you see that there's no decimal appearing now. If I change it to 5, say, and reload, then you see that there are 5 decimal places appearing now. By default, it falls back to 2. So if you don't specify any value, it will show you just 2 decimal places. Okay, so the next thing we have is, I guess, it's number. It's pretty much like currency, but it does not add or remove any signs or whatever. So it would pretty much work like a regular formatted number with the same flag you can specify with the number of decimals by default, and it would just format your number nicely to show the decimals as well. And if I change it to 5, you see, then we have got a number like this. So that's pretty much not the advanced level of filters in Angular, but yeah, you have successfully learned the basics of filters in Angular.js. So that's it. It wasn't hard, was it? So that's it for filters for this tutorial, and we'll be exploring filters more in Angular.js in further tutorials. And till then, stay tuned with me. Don't forget to subscribe, and thank you for watching. I'll see you then.